and now we will give the recognition of the Lifetime Achievement Award. The Lifetime Achievement Award is given to someone who has committed his or her life to serving the community with dignity and integrity. This year's Lifetime Achievement Awardee, Ida Goodwin Wolfolk, is a member. All right, okay. Yeah, give her an applause. She's a member of the St. Louis community who has spent her life raising awareness about injustice while promoting diversity and trying to build a better future for all. Please welcome again Dr. Henry Gibbons, President Emeritus of Harris Stowe State University, to give some personal remarks and present Ms. Goodwin Wolfolk with the Lifetime Achievement Award.
Miss Ida Goodwin Wolfolk. Ida and I were reared in the same North St. Louis neighborhood, the historic Beale area. The Gibbons and Goodwin families were extremely close during those great days in the Beale. I knew early on that Ida would grow up to become a major force in the entire St. Louis community. I am very proud to say that Ida is a graduate of Harris Teachers College, now Harris Stowe State University, and has received the Alumni Award for Distinguished Community Service. Ida is a recipient of many local, state, and national awards and serves on numerous boards and commissions. A detailed description of Ida's fabulous career is printed in this evening's program. I encourage each of you to take a few moments to read it. Ida is currently a consultant to Dr. David Stewart, Chairman of the Board of Directors of Worldwide Technology, the nation's number one African American business in the nation. Ida continues to be a passionate advocate for all that makes St. Louis a better place to live, work, and play. Anyone who knows Ida, as I do, can honestly attest to the fact that there is no one in the world like her. Ladies and gentlemen, I am very proud to present to you this evening my good friend, Ida Goodwin Wolfolk, known nationally as the Toastmistress General, and this year's Monsanto Family YMCA Lifetime Achievement Awardee. Congratulations to Ida.
I'm Ida Goodwin Wolfolk.
How does the YMCA mission line up with your personal beliefs?
Well, since there are only four letters in the whole name, YMCA, I think that's very simple. I think it's that C. It used to be the Y, the young part, and now it's the C, the Christian part. Any organization that can last that many years and still hold on to that basic word, Christian, I think is very important and very key, because all of us now like to be politically correct and add things, delete things, take them away. And you know, you don't have to add or take away from the word Christian. And so young people who come here are brought up with those ideals in mind. And that to me is very key about the mission of the Young Men's Christian Association.
Do you have a personal story you would like to share about an experience with the YMCA?
Yes, I do. When I was a teenager, or very early in college, I was a tri-highway advisor. Because to me, I thought that was really big time, that I could be over these people that were coming after school to learn things about etiquette and careers, etc. I wasn't much older than they were. But I see them from time to time now. And there are some successful people out there, all who came through the tri-highway experience. Also, my late father, B.W. Goodwin, was a very close friend of one of the former directors here when it was Page Park Y, that was Henry Lenoir. And so a lot of times when I was in the car going from place to place with my dad, then I would listen to Mr. Lenoir and my dad talk about all the issues in the city. And it was amazing how many issues the YMCA was involved in, even at that level. It was the place to be. It was a community mecca. And also, during my college years at Harris Stowe, I would work here during holidays, because kids then, of course, their parents still had to work, and I held the all-day program right here at this site for young people. And we had a ball here. We played, we sang, I had to bring somebody else to help with the crafts, because that's not me. But we did all kinds of activities during the week that they were out for Christmas and Easter. And I enjoyed that. And I still have that on my resume.
How does it feel to accept the Lifetime Achievement Award for the 13th Annual Montana Family YMCA Tuxedo and Tennis Gala?
First of all, when you get a call or a letter saying Lifetime, you wonder, oh my goodness, Lifetime, is it over? And I want you all to know that for me, it's not over. I still have miles to go before I sleep. But thank God for this wonderful award. And my only regret is that my late mom and dad, Myrtle Goodwin and B.W. Goodwin, could not be here to see this. But I'm very thankful that my daughter, Sarah, and her husband, Chris, and my grandsons, Christopher and Caleb, are here from Portsmouth, Virginia. And I'd also like to say that I'm still very godly proud that there's a walk here that is called the Ida Goodwin Wolf Oak Walk. And I have so many friends who come over here and walk. And of course I do too. I mean, I look like I've been walking as much as I need to, but I do walk. And so when I don't get a chance to walk, I tell my friends, put another lap in for me. Because everything now is geared toward the healthy life. And your quality of life is much improved when our health is improved too. So I thank God for the YMCA and for this wonderful, wonderful award. I'm in very good company. The other people that I did the video with today are dear friends of mine and the others. It's such a wonderful honor. And as the song says, you didn't have to do it, but you did. Thank you so much.
Another round of applause, and we're going to hear more from Ida. That is an example of what we mean in this election. Obviously, she's on stage receiving her.